All right. So as marketers, sometimes we target groups of consumers, and then other times our target is really other businesses. So we still need to figure out the best way to segment our markets. That leads us to the question of how do we segment business markets? Well, a meaningful difference between our business customers would be how frequently they purchase. If we have a business that just purchases from us once a year or once a month, well, they need different levels of attention versus somebody who's buying from us every week. So that could be a big difference between businesses in our market. Another characteristic that we look at for segmenting business markets is customer type. In other words, are we dealing with a manufacturer who uses our product in their product? Or are we dealing with a government agency? Or for that matter, are we dealing with a retailer? These are all businesses that might buy from us, and their plan for how to use our product is going to make a big difference in how we should market to them. So customer type is another good way to segment business markets. In a similar fashion, businesses in different industries are going to be quite different, and it could be because of how they use our product, or really, it could also just be because of the nature of their income or the demand on their products. All sorts of differences come from industry to industry. Next, we have geography. And just like in consumer markets, the geographic location of businesses will tend to make a difference in what they need from us, how they use the product, all sorts of other things, how we get product to them. So geography can be a meaningful difference in business markets as well. Then I've alluded to this next one a couple of times already, but product use is a pretty useful way to break up the market. In other words, what are they going to do with the product? And this could be different even with the same product from business to business. So a lot of times this could guide our marketing efforts. How is the customer, in this case a business, going to use our product? Lastly, different customers in the business market will use different purchase processes. In other words, sometimes a business may just send you an order, an email, or some other digital order that says, we need 10 more of that. On the other hand, it could be like a government agency where every single time they buy something, they have to submit it or put it out for bid, where we as a seller would have to go and make a proposal or give them a bid for how much it would cost to buy from us. So that's a very meaningful difference in terms of what we need to do to serve that segment. Together, all of these different characteristics of business markets can help us to break down that market into meaningful and useful segments.